In this video, I'll show you how to get a free SSL certificate with the most up-to-date method in 2020. I'll split this into three parts, which is verification, installation, and activation. So at the end of this video, your not secure message will be a green lock, guaranteed. Visit sslforfree.com and create a free account. Now, you'll need to click on New Certificate and enter the website name you want your free SSL certificate to be installed on, and click Next Step. Choose the 90-day certificate as it's the free one, and click Next Step again. Leave these options as Auto-Generate CSR and click Next Step. Choose the free version, and then click Next Step for the final time, and wait a bit for it to load. This might take like 10 or 20 seconds, so don't worry, it didn't crash. Here we have three different methods of proving that the website name you typed in earlier actually belongs to you. I'm going to show you all three methods of verification, but you only need to do one. And I'm going to use GoDaddy and cPanel for this, but it works on absolutely any web hosting provider if you can access one of the three things, which is File Manager, Email Manager, or the DNS Manager. By the way, if you don't want to go through all of this trouble, you can get web hosting plans that have free automatic SSLs, meaning you don't have to do anything, included with every purchase, like Bluehost or SiteGround. I'll leave discount codes in the description down below. Navigate to your cPanel. As I've mentioned before, I'll be using GoDaddy as an example, and then find the Email Account section. Click on it. Once it's fully loaded, click the blue Create button and type in admin as your username. Think of a password for your email and click Create again. Once the email is created, you'll want to go back to SSL for free, click Next Step, and then click Verify Domain. Go back to your cPanel, and next to your newly created email box, click Check Email. After some time, it took me like 2 or 3 minutes, you'll receive two emails. Open them, click on Go to Verification page, and paste in the code that was sent in the email. Now, do exactly the same steps with another email that you should have received as well. Once you're done, go back to SSL for free and refresh the page. If you validated correctly, you should see a button that says Install Certificate. Click on it. If you see the Install Certificate message, then good job, that means you did everything correctly, and you can skip to this part in the video for the rest of the tutorial. But if for some reason it didn't work, keep watching, I'll show you two more methods of verification that might work for you. Choose the DNS CNAME option, then go into your GoDaddy control panel. Near your domain names, click DNS, scroll down and click Add. From the list, choose CNAME, and in the Host tab, copy and paste the name without your domain name. I'm not sure why, but it doesn't work if you copy and paste everything, at least for GoDaddy. So you need to copy and paste everything before the first dot. Then copy and paste everything from the Points 2 tab into the Points 2 tab on GoDaddy. And finally, for TTL, choose half an hour and click Save. Go back to SSL for free, click Next Step, and then Verify Domain. So you should see this screen if everything went successfully, and you can skip to this part in the video for the rest of the tutorial. But even if this didn't work, then keep watching, I'll show you the final method of verification that's guaranteed to work. Click here to download your authentication files. Once the download is complete, access File Manager from your cPanel. You'll now need to find a folder that contains the files of the website you're trying to get an SSL for. It can be named the same as your domain name or public_HTML. If you don't already have a folder named .well-known inside, create one yourself by clicking on plus folder. Inside this folder, create another folder called PKI-validation. And simply upload the files you've downloaded earlier inside PKI-validation. If you did everything correctly, you should see a similar screen when you click the link from SSL for free. Finally, just click Next Step and verify domain. So it doesn't matter which of the three methods you use to verify, as long as you can download your certificate, you're good to go. So here's what to do once you have your certificate. Click on Download Certificate. This is where all the files for your SSL certificate are located. Once the download is complete, click Next Step. Open up the zip file that you've downloaded and you'll see three files inside of it. Save them somewhere on your computer. The location doesn't really matter, just remember where you put them. Once the files are on your computer, go back to cPanel, find and click on the SSL/TLS option, and then click Manage SSL Sites. Select the website name you want your certificate to be installed on. Now, we'll need to open the three files that we've downloaded earlier with some sort of a text editing program. I'll do it with Notepad, as I feel most people should have that on their computer. Just right-click on certificate.crt, choose Open With. If you don't see Notepad, click More Apps, find Notepad, and click OK. Now copy-paste all of this text into the certificate box on cPanel. Now for the private key, you'll want to right-click on it, then choose Properties. Near the Open With tab, click Change, then choose More Apps, and once again find the Notepad. Now you'll be able to open it, so copy and paste all of the text into the private key box on cPanel. And finally, for the certificate authority bundle, do exactly the same as with certificate before. Right-click on it and open it using Notepad. Finally, copy and paste everything, then click Install Certificate. A lot of the work is now done. You have the SSL certificate installed, so you need to force people to use it because users can still access the unsecure version of your website. So in this next part, I'll show you how to do that using a WordPress plugin. Go into your WordPress dashboard. You can reach it by typing the website name followed by /login. If that doesn't work, try /wp-admin. Once inside WordPress, navigate to plugins, then click Add New and search for Really Simple SSL. Then click Install and Activate. When you activate, you'll see this Go Ahead and Activate SSL button. Once you click the button, your SSL will be fully working and your site will have the secure tag. If you're using WordPress, this should be it. Your website will now be secured by an SSL certificate for 90 days, and once the 90 days are up, you'll just have to redo these steps and install a new certificate. Now, even the people that use the HTTP version get automatically redirected to HTTPS. So there's actually no way anyone can reach the unsecure version of your website. But be very careful with this. You can actually get locked out of your website or your WordPress admin panel if you uninstall the SSL certificate or it expires before you renew. Because what happens is you force people to use the secure version, but you no longer have the secure version. So you understand how that creates a problem. So be very, very careful with this. Have a backup somewhere of your website if this happens. And if you don't want for this to happen, simply use a web hosting provider that gives automatic free SSL certificates, like Bluehost and SiteGround. I'll leave discount coupons for these providers in the description down below. If you found this tutorial useful, consider subscribing because my channel is all about web hosting and website related tutorials. Also, if you're having any troubles with this, feel free to leave a comment down below. I'll try to answer and help you out the best I can. As always, good luck making your websites, and I'll see you in the next video.